saint to celebrate today. Today we commemorate the life and ministry of Saint Matthias. We hear about Matthias today in our first reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of your truth. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the Good Shepherd, leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace be your will. We praise you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God and King, O God of my Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone, the Holy One, Lord, the Lord, the Lord, our most popular Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who assigned Saint Matthias a place in the College of Apostles, grant us through his intercession that, rejoicing at how your love has been allotted to us, we may merit to be numbered among the elect. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter stood up in the midst of the brothers and sisters. There was a group of about 120 persons in one place. He said, "My brothers and sisters, the scripture had to be fulfilled, which the Holy Spirit spoke beforehand through the mouth of David concerning Judas, who was the guard for those who arrested Jesus. Judas was numbered among us and was allotted a share in this ministry. For it is written in the book of Psalms that his encampment become desolate and may no one dwell in it, and may another take his office. Therefore, it is necessary that one of the men who accompanied us the whole time the Lord Jesus came and went among us, beginning from the baptism of John until the day on which he was taken from us, become with us a witness to his resurrection." So they proposed too, Joseph called Barsabbas, who was also known as Justus, and Matthias. Then they prayed, "You, Lord, who know the hearts of all, show which one of these two you have chosen to take the place in this apostolic ministry, from which Judas turned away to go to his own place." Then they gave lots to them, and the lot fell upon Matthias, and he was counted with the 11 apostles. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people. The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people. Praise you, servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord, both now and forever.
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people.
From the rising to the setting of the sun is the name of the Lord to be praised. High above all nations is the Lord. Above the heavens is his glory.
The Lord made the sea with the leaders of his people.
Who is like the Lord our God, who is enthroned on high, and looks upon the heavens and the earth below?
The Lord made the sea with the leaders of his people.
He raises up the lowly from the dust. From the dunghill he lifts up the poor, to seat them with princes, with the princes of his own people.
The Lord will give him the sea with the leaders of his two people.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy might be in you, and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment, love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends, if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you, and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you. Love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
When someone at your table makes an unkind remark about someone not present, or says something cutting and demeaning to someone who is, the lot falls on you. When you're asked to contribute your considerable talent to an important cause, the lot falls on you. When you're outraged at the hurt and pain endured by an innocent victim of violence or greed, the lot falls on you. Today we celebrate the feast of St. Matthias, a member of Jesus' company who was called to take the place of Judas. Today could have just as been easily been called the Feast of St. Barsabbas, but as the story from the Acts tells us, the lot fell on Matthias. And it seems a strange way to elect someone to a position of authority. But in matters of faith, of justice, of being a peacemaker, God has chosen each of us in baptism to carry on the work of Jesus. And so the lot always falls on us. With trust in God's love, we now lift up our prayers to him. For the Pilgrim Church on Earth, that reflecting God's judges, may God's grace strengthen them in upholding fairness and justice. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the lonely and all who struggle with grief and loss, may the love of Jesus be their comfort and consolation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in vocations in our parish community, may God open the hearts of those God is calling. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our loved ones and all who have died, especially Kevin Benton, that rejoicing with all the saints, their joy may be complete. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Helen McLaughlin, for whom we remember especially at this Mass, and for what or for whom do we pray for today?
For a successful surgery and a speedy recovery for Mitter Mallory, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For healing and recovery for my Frank and Nita Rodman and all of those suffering from cancer, let us pray to the
Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
For a family member with a very serious ailment, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the country that we're around in mercy.
We've got a lot of ambulances and fire trucks at our house this morning. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have received our blessed prayer shawls that they may be comforted, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For comfort and consolation for Lee and for his family, let us pray to our Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving for our granddaughter, Charlie, as she celebrates her 16th birthday today, may her life be always blessed with the love of the Lord and all those around her. I pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father in heaven, we thank you for your kindness and faithfulness. Hear and answer our prayers today according to your wisdom, for we make them through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept your sacrifice
in your hands, for the praise of the Lord. Receive, O Lord, the offerings of your church, reverently presented for the feast of St. Matthias, and through them strengthen us by the power of your grace, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, for you, eternal shepherd, do not desert your flock, but through the blessed apostles, watch over it and protect it always, so that it may be governed by those you have appointed shepherds to lead it in the name of your Son. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed be he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
O Lord, you are indeed holy, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, Lord, until you come. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, your people spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, William, our Bishop, and all the clergy and religious. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, the martyrs, Saint Matthias, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
We pray the words that Christ taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith and courage of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the risen Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer one another the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Happy are we called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room,
but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Never cease, O Lord, we pray, to fill your family with divine gifts, and through the blessed Matthias' intercession for us, graciously admit us to a share in the lot of the saints in light, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please join me in singing our Eucharistic hymn number 9.